since we're getting ready to do a pasture change, what I've done is set an alley up here that heads us up to the gate. I had the cows at the furthest part in this pasture, and I've already gave them a call, and they're heading this way. Now, the way I've done this is I've also extended this alley right out through the pasture that we'll be crossing through, and right around, actually right through the trees is where we're going over there. But we have to go out this way through the gate, out and around through another pasture to get through there. There's a creek that runs through here. So, come on, girls. Yep. Apologize for the bumps, but I wanted to share the experience and what it takes to move cows from pasture to pasture. Basically, you work with the cows. I don't put any pressure on them. We're low stress here. I let them move at their speed, and I'm all right with that. Come on, girls. Yep, yep, yep. There's the gate right here. And there's my alleyway that goes up and around the corner, up around this small woods here. I learned a long time ago that if I don't set this alleyway up for them to get out of, this is a 25-acre pasture, and the cows will explore it all on their own time if I just let them head this way without an alley. The first couple years, I watched them run right by the gate and run to that side of the pasture, or run right back by the gate and run back down to they were. So I learned the alley is my friend. Come on, girls. Yep. Pretty good looking crew, 34 head, not enormous by any means. I'm trying to regraze where they were a little bit. I don't like that, but it is what it is. I can't stop it. Come on, girls. Here we go. You're getting excited. You're getting excited, girls. Come on, girls. Hip, 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 hip. Hip. On up around the corner, girls. A lot of people believe that when the cows are running, they're in stress, but you got to look at the reason they're running. This reason is excitement. They're happy. It's not because they're scared or there's too much pressure putting on them. You're fat. That's why you're wore out. Don't go on a diet, though. Keep eating, girl. There's my tail. Okay, so now we need to put pressure on them a little bit, or at least encourage them to realize the gate down here is open. Come on, girl. Just as simple as that. Ah, didn't get to come back. I got the gate closed before you got back here. Okay, that's pretty much a pasture move. I got their first paddock set up over there. We'll let them work their way back into the paddocks, and I'll go get their water and mineral salt and get them set up. Until I get back, there is a little stream right here they've got to cross, so that will be their source of water until I get back here. There you go, a pasture move. Seemed pretty simple, but what you didn't see was the 25 to 30 minutes worth of setup of the poly stakes and the alleys. Now they're gonna run around and check out their paddocks. It's a good day. It's a good day on the farm. We are happy cows. Moo power. Everybody moved in. Got their mineral feeder moved over. And their water's just up there on the other side of that black cow. So everything's set up. This is where they'll be today. Right on the other side of this black cow is the poly wire that keeps them from going any further that way. And then there's another one just on the other side of those two black cows that keeps them from going to that side. So they're stuck in this paddocks, this section or this corner of the pasture. And we'll just leapfrog this away, our way across this side. This side of this pasture until we get into that field. We'll work across it, and then I'll come back across that side of the paddocks and right back out the gate and work back towards the front. So it's constantly moving and constantly eating. It's like a finely oiled machine.